Hey guys, welcome to this Laravel technique video. In this one, we're going to take a look at how to build this cookie pop-up over here in the left-hand corner. If you're not familiar with cookies, they're basically used to manage user sessions, personal preferences, and to track any kind of user behavior. Now, there's many ways to implement a cookie pop-up or cookies. So I'm going to take a really straightforward approach with this one using Laravel 9 and some packages. So we'll get you started. And we'll also have some functionality where we can try to like click away and close this thing if you stick around for the end of the tutorial. Okay, thanks for jumping in. Let's get started. So next up, we're gonna have to put some contents or something inside of this template, this layout file, in order for the file to have some contents. So we're just gonna like pretty much borrow it. So we're just gonna copy that and we're just gonna paste this in here. So I've really just kind of duplicated the guest layout file in a way. If we go back to the browser and we refresh, still there should be no changes. And the reason is because once again, the file in question, the welcome.blade file, is not pulling any information in from the site.blade file that we mimicked by copying the code from the guest.blade file to the site.blade file. So what we'll do here is we will implement a component, and the component's going to be called what we called the layout file. In this case, it'll be site layout. If you wanted to add contents to it or something besides just what we're doing from this tutorial, you could do something like this, and then you could play something like this is the content or whatever with inside this. And if you go back over to the browser, you'll see that it renders what's inside of those tags. All right, let's remove this and do some work around Composer. So we're gonna jump to the terminal, and inside the terminal, we're just gonna go up just to the root directory here. And we're just gonna do a quick list. So we're in the right place. We'll clear this. We're going to do some work with Composer. If you're not familiar with Composer and you don't have it installed or you're not sure how to do that, be sure to check out the videos on this channel on how to work with Composer. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the command Composer and we're going to search. And what we're going to search for is anything related with cookies. Okay. So we're going to type this. So what this has done, it's really equivalent to kind of just going here. I'm going to click on this for a moment. And this is the repo, it's called packages.org. And if you were to search here for any cookie related content, you'll see that, you know, a bunch of packages and libraries come up relating to cookies. So the one that we're gonna use is this one by Spotty. Okay, so I'm gonna close this and I'm gonna jump back here. So we're gonna require this package. So I'm just gonna highlight this. Okay, I'm gonna copy it. And then I'm gonna say Composer require and the package. At this point, the package will automatically register itself, but we're gonna optionally publish the config file. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna use PHP artisan. That is the command, but I just like to use aliases. So I'm just gonna say PA for PHP artisan, and I'm gonna use vendor publish. And we can take a look at what is available to be published right around here. So this value is number 11 here, and it's the Spotty cookie consent service provider. Okay, so that's what we're looking for. So we could hit that number 11. What has happened here is we published three specific files to these correlating directories, and we can take a look at those. So the first one is in the config file, and it should pop up as right here, cookie consent. We'll get to that in a moment. And the next one was published in the lang directory under vendor, and it'll be cookie consent. And the one that we'll take a look at will be right here under the English variation. And these are all the localization type files that are available with this vendor package. The next one is in the resources directory. And this one specifically is in the vendor folder, and it resides right here under the directory cookie consent. And we'll take a look at these two files as well.
What do you mean I left the video on?
Oh, snap. Yo, I gotta go. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna get back to work and you guys get back to the video. Okay. They're still there. All right, I'm going. So this is our welcome blade file. This is the cookie consent config file. And basically what this does is allows us to tweak some of the settings available with this package. So for instance, we could set something like the duration is set to this by default, but maybe we don't want it to be that long. You know, maybe we'll make it, you know, times two or something like that, right? So that's the lifetime or the life of the cookie saved in the session in the browser. And, you know, for here, this is the actual cookie name. So, I mean, we could change this name to whatever you like or whatever's applicable to your application. You know, we could say, so Kevin likes, you know, cookies. And everything else we can kind of leave as default. So this text.php file, which is located in the lang directory, which is over here under the vendor and cookie consent, this is where you would place any kind of dialogue that you want to have in the modal or pop-up box that you're going to have. Over here, this is some of the styling that comes along with this package. And as you can see, it's using Tailwind, which is why we set up the project the way we did in the beginning. You could follow through and do some kind of other implementation with Tailwind, and that would still work. So this is where we would configure that. And as you can see here, it's being translated or has the ability to be translated based on, you know, the message, which is found here. Okay. And also the agree text right here, which is also found here. So if we were to change this to something like, let's say, sure, and we change this message, it would literally just apply. Next up, we have the index.php file, which is located in the vendors directory under resources, and it's in the cookie consent folder. So I'd recommend if you're new, just kind of leave this one alone. Now we're going to add the dialog box that comes with the package. So we're going to use a include, and we are going to call the cookie consent index. So that file that I had said, you know, maybe we shouldn't mesh with it if you're fairly new, we're going to call this. Next up, we're going to need to render this or run, you know, Webpack, which is right down here. We're going to need to run npm run dev to kind of, you know, compile all the Tailwind that is associated with that file. So down here, you can run npm run dev or npm run watch, depending how you have that set up or you'd like to set that up. Once again, I'm just going to use an alias. I'm going to say npm run dev. Let's jump over to our browser. This is what the package looks like by default, and notice that we changed that word to sure instead of whatever it was before, and it applies. So this is great. It's working, but we want to take this just a little bit further, and we're going to style this in a certain way and make some adjustments. So stick around for the next lesson on that one. And that's it for this one, guys. Don't forget to like the video if you found this useful. Leave your comments and thoughts below. Take care, and I will see you next time.